Hello. Welcome back to the module 3. In the last module, I discussed about metal determination of total metal and how to use those total metal to grossly understand the quality of the environment and assess the quality of the environment or quality of the sediments, and then further assess the quality of the marine system. But we found that we need to have a better tool, and now come up with a new tool which is known as metal speciation. Now, first, what is metal speciation? So before I go with metal speciation study, discuss about metal speciation, I want to give a brief story about it. In Japan, there is a bay called Minamata. There was a company named Chiso. They established they were established in 1950s, I guess, and they were producing plastic, and they were using mercury as a catalyst, and they used to dump those unused mercury into the coastal area of Japan in Minamata. And what Minamata was a fishing port, and Japanese, they eat either raw or half cooked fish. And in 1945 onwards, they started producing plastic. So from that time onwards, they started dumping mercury in the Minamata area. And what they found around 1952, they found, the cats were showing some unusual behavior. They were going very close to the water, and they were jumping as if they were committing suicide. And initially, it was known as cat suicide disease. And, people were not knowing. Then eventually, after 10 years, almost 1,000 people died because of unknown reason. And they had some unusual symptoms. And then it took another 10 years to realize that whatever the mercury was deposited by the company got, which are not very toxic in general, but they realized that it is not the mercury, elemental mercury, which were dumped there. It was the methyl mercury, which were the bacteria in the coastal areas that converted those mercury to methyl mercury, which is a neurotoxin, created such kind of havoc in Minamata. And that mercury poisoning is known as Minamata disease. So at that time, scientists realized that it is not the total metal concentration, identification of the metal complexes or species in an environment, whether it is marine or natural environment, is very important. So any field that deals with identification of the species is called speciation. So in this module, we'll discuss about metal speciation, identification of metal species, and how that helps to assess the quality of the environment. So speciation is basically identify the specific form of an element, either based on their electronic or oxidation state, complex or molecular structure. In natural environment, there are so many complexes, it becomes very difficult to isolate particularly one. So even the process of classifying of an analyte or group of analytes from a certain samples according to physical and chemical properties is also can be considered as speciation, or more crudely, fractionation. So this speciation can help us in understanding the mobility, stability, bioavailability, and movement of metals in different biotic and abiotic compartment of the marine system. So here again, I mentioned mercury and methyl mercury. Similarly, if you look at total chromium concentration in sediment, it doesn't give you any information about how much chromium-6, which is toxic, and how much chromium-3 present into the system. But speciation study can help you to estimate chromium-6 concentration in the system. So if you look at total chromium concentration or total mercury concentration, that will not help you in assessing the quality of the sediments or the environment. But if you can quantify the concentration of methyl mercury or concentration of chromium-6 into the system, then that will give you much better information about the quality of the environment. So what is metal speciation? Another example. Say if you take a copper sheet and keep it outside into your garden, in the garden, you will see after a few days, you get such kind of blue, green, different color on the copper sheet. And these green colors are not copper, are not pure copper. It is some compound which has formed while staying outside the in the garden, because there are so many different types of complexing agents, natural complexing agents present in the environment that helps this copper to form different copper complexes. And these copper complexes are having completely different chemical properties than the pure copper. So this change, if you look at total copper concentration here, and if you look at the species, will be completely different. Total copper concentration may be same, but the species will be completely different. So we need speciation to identify those different species because they have different biological activities. Similarly, here I showed how iron, if you keep it outside, it got rusted, and there are so many oxides, different types of oxide probably present in the second type of chain. So you know, you can here also, you know, speciation got changed completely in the environment. So what happens if we keep metals? Metal can be in different forms in marine environments as well as in natural environment. It can be it can form a complex with inorganic ligands. It can form complexes with humic substances. It can be in the form of metal colloids. It can associate with organisms. It can be associated with protein. It can be associated with solid. It can be associated with organic matters. So in different forms, there are so many other forms also it can be present in marine or natural environment. So identification of those different forms are very important to assess there. So here is an example. So lead in marine environment, it can be present as free lead ion. It can be in the form of lead bicarbonate, which these both the forms will be can be in solution. They are in dissolved phase. It can form complexes with dissolved organic matter like fulvic acid or humic acid, and it can be in the dissolved phase, it can be in the water column. It can get adsorbed on the iron oxyhydroxides, like, you know, which is gelatinous. It can get trapped on the surface of iron oxyhydroxides, and which is colloidal in nature. Ultimately, it settles down and settles at the bottom of the sediments. It can be associated with organic soils, it can be held within the structure of the sediments. So, you know, lead can be present in different forms in marine environment. So identification of these different forms is very important to identify their mobility, their bioavailability, and their fate in different marine systems. So what are the factors that affect speciation? You know, pH and ionic strength of a system affects speciation tremendously. The redox condition of the environment is also very important. What kind of ligands present in the system? What is ligand? That I will come in the coming slide. So natural ligands, what kind of ligands are present? Quantity and quality of natural ligands, both dissolved organic carbon and particulate, is also very important things which affects the speciation. Then concentration of metal in the sediments is very important, and competition of other metals in the system. So these are the factors that affects. I cannot go and explain each one here, but I'm just giving a brief idea about different factors. I will provide the materials that probably you can go through it, and if you have questions, you can contact us. So what is ligand? I mentioned natural ligands. So ligands are basically, they're having an atom with a lone pair that can, you know, donate that atom having electron pair, and that can be donated to a metal ion, which is positively charged, and form a complex. So ligand, an atom or ion or molecule that donates or shares electrons with one or more central atom or ions, metal ligand bonds, forms, which are usually covalent in nature. And they form, and sometimes they form a chelates, like, you know, a ring structure with extra high stability. So these are ligands. These are present in, like, nitrate, sulfate, phosphate. These are natural, these are inorganic ligands. But if you look at organic ligands, natural organic ligands, they are very complex, very complex. You just consider this one. This is one of the tentative structures of humic substances. So what is humic substances? You know, when you see trees, the leaves, tree leaves you know, after they fall, they degrade. From green, they turn brown, and ultimately they mix with the soil, and then it becomes almost, you know, brown color material. These materials are nothing but humic substances. These are partially degraded leaves where, you know, you get humic substances. The tentative structure is like this, which is very simple tentative structure has been proposed. You can understand how complex it can be. So these humic substances are supramolecular association of small organic molecules. They stay together by van der Waals attraction or by hydrogen bond, and they behave like a big molecules like this, but they changes their structure. If you decrease the pH, that is, if you increase the acidity, then several humic acid molecules, they come close together and they aggregate and they form a bigger molecules, and you know, binding sites decreases and metal complexation capacity also decreases. They have lots of, but I should mention here, these humic substances, they have lots of binding sites which can bind metals and can prevent metals to become bioavailable. And if you increase the pH, that is, make it basic, then the molecules become smaller in size, and this is called disaggregation process, and that can also affect metal speciation. This is a small structure of fulvic acid. Fulvic acid usually smaller than the humic acid. The comparison I will give you later. Study material. Now here you can see that iron oxyhydroxide, this is an inorganic ligand which can host metal as well, just like humic substances. So here you can see with increasing pH, what happens? Usually the metals got attached to it. Here you can see metals are here. Lead is the example here. Leads are attached to it. This should be decreasing pH. Decreasing pH, that means you are increasing H positive ion concentration, and that releases this lead from here, and then it comes only H positive. So bioavailability of metal increases. Now similarly, these humic substances can get adsorbed on the surface of iron oxyhydroxide and can behave like a very complex molecules, and these natural ligands affect metal speciation. So in sediments, we have different metal binding phases. Like, you know, metals can be bound to exchangeable carbonate bicarbonate forms, or it can be in pore water, it can be in water soluble form, it can be you know, complexed with organic matters, it can be within the structure of the sediments, or it can be with iron oxyhydroxide. The metals which are within the structure of the sediment is called residual metals, and these metals are not bioavailable. They don't usually move because they are present within the lattice of the structure, so usually they are not bioavailable, and we should not bother about it, because that is the reason I mentioned, you know, India has a long coastline with different, you know, the geology of the adjacent land is also very different. So the minerals that get eroded from the land and get deposited in the coastal areas can have different, you know, metal concentration in their residual fraction, and that can mislead us to understand metal distribution and their pollution. Just if we grossly look at the total metal concentration. Now here I have given an example. These metals form different types of complexes with different stability. I have given an example here, like, you know, five-star hotel built, then chawl, and then ultimately footpath. The stability is highly stable here in the five-star hotel, people who are sleeping on the footpath are very unstable. So here metal also can form very strong complexes, very stable complexes with humic substances, but at the same time it can be it can form very weak complexes in different binding sites present in the humic substances. So ultimately these things nature of the humic substances, number of binding sites, and the nature of the metals and their complexation with the natural ligands can have impact on the bioavailability. If it is forming a weaker complexes, then the bioavailability will be more and the mobility will be more. But if it forms a stable complexes, then the bioavailability of the metal will be less. So here I showed the distribution pattern of copper, nickel and lead in different fraction around India. And it shows a major fraction of metals are all the metals were associated as fraction 2. as fraction 2. You know, here it is the fraction 2 where the major part of the total metal concentration were present as fraction 2. So from here, we see that iron manganese oxyhydroxide is the major hosting phase for almost a copper, nickel, and lead around India. And organic carbon is the second, sedimentary organic matter is the second highest hosting phase for metals. And, you know, labile complexes, and we also found that with the increasing metal concentration, the stability of the metal complexes also decreases in sediment. So summary from here, we found that metal speciation study can be very useful to assess the quantity and quality of an environment, and natural ligand act as a buffer to control metal pollution or bind bioavailable metals and reduces metal pollution and its mobility. And iron manganese oxyhydroxide is the major hosting phase for different metals in the shelf sediments around India. So in this module, I discussed about this metal speciation. So in the next module, I'll talk about how this metal speciation or metal, what will be the scenario with respect of metal pollution with respect to climate change. Thank you.